Delano dropped to his knees in the dark forest. He heard Evie among them crying as she burned to death, unseen, unknown, alone. He let Oathbringer slip from his fingers and shatter to mist.
Son of Honor.
He opened his eyes to find himself in a tiny clearing bathed in starlight. A shadow moved in the darkness beyond the trees.
Hello, human. You smell of desperation.
The elongated figure moved among the trees, ringing the clearing, stalking him like a predator.
They say you can change a man.
The night watcher seeped from the darkness. She was a dark green mist, vaguely shaped like a crawling person. Two long arms reached out, pulling her along as she floated above the ground. Her essence, like a tail, extended far behind her, weaving among tree trunks and disappearing into the forest. Indistinct and vaporous, she flowed like a river or an eel, and the only part of her with any specific detail was her smooth, feminine face. She glided toward him until her nose was mere inches from his own, her silken black eyes meeting his. Tiny hands sprouted from the misty sides of her head. They reached out, taking his face and touching it with a thousand cold yet gentle caresses.
What is it you wish of me? What boon drives you, son of Honor, son of Odium?
She started to circle him. The tiny black hands kept touching his face, but their arms stretched out, becoming tentacles.
What would you like? Renown? Wealth? Skill? Would you like to be able to swing a sword and never tire?
No.
Beauty? Followers? I can feed your dreams, make you glorious.
Her dark mists wrapped around him. The tiny tendrils tickled his skin. She brought her face right up to his again.
What is your boon?
Forgiveness.
The Night Watcher's tendrils dodged away from his face like splayed fingers. She leaned back, pursing her lips.
Perhaps it is possessions you wish. Spheres, gemstones, shards. A blade that bleeds darkness and cannot be defeated. I can give it to you.
Please, tell me. Can I ever be forgiven?
It wasn't what he'd intended to request. He couldn't remember what he'd intended to request. The Night Watcher curled around him, agitated.
Forgiveness is no boon. What should I do to you? What should I give you? Speak it, human.
That is enough, child.
The Night Watcher backed away from him in a sharp motion. Hesitant, Dalinar turned and found a woman with brown skin, the color of dark wood bark, standing at the edge of the clearing. She had a matronly build and wore a sweeping brown dress.
Mother! Mother! He came to me! I was going to bless him!
Thank you, child, but this boon is beyond you. You may attend me, Dalinar Kholin.
Numbed by the surreal spectacle, Dalinar stood up.
Who are you?
Someone beyond your authority to question.
She strode into the forest, and Dalinar joined her. Moving through the underbrush seemed easier now, though the vines and branches pulled toward the strange woman. Her dress seemed to meld with it all, the brown cloth becoming bark or grass. The Night Watcher curled along beside them, her dark mist flowing through the holes in the underbrush. Dalinar found her distinctly unnerving.
You must forgive my daughter. This is the first time in centuries I've come personally to speak with one of you.
Then this isn't how it happens every time?
Of course not. I let her hold court here. It helps her understand you.
What? Why did you choose to come out now?
Because of the attention others pay you. And what did I tell you of demanding questions? Why have you come here, human? Do you not serve Honor, the one you call Almighty? Look unto him for forgiveness.
I asked the Ardens. I didn't get what I wanted.
You got what you deserved. The truth you have crafted for yourselves.
I am doomed, then. They weep, Mother. I hear them when I close my eyes. All around me, begging me to save them. They're driving me mad.
She contemplated him, the Night Watcher twining around her legs, then around Dalinar's, then back again. This woman, she was more than he could see. Vines from her dress curled into the earth, permeating everything. In that moment, he knew that he was not seeing her, but instead a fragment with which he could interact.
This woman extends into eternity.
This will be your boon. I will not make of you the man you can become. I will not give you the aptitude or the strength, nor will I take from you your compulsions. But I will give you a pruning. A careful excision to let you grow. The cost will be high.
Please, anything.
In doing this, I provide for him a weapon. Dangerous, very dangerous. Yet, all things must be cultivated. What I take from you will grow back eventually. This is part of the cost. It will do me well to have a part of you, even if you ultimately become his. You were always bound to come to me. I control all things that can be grown, nurtured. That includes the thorns.
She seized him. And the trees descended, the branches, the vines. The forest curled around him and crept into the crevices around his eyes, under his fingernails, into his mouth and ears, into his pores.
A boon and a curse. That is how it is done. I will take these things from your mind, and with them, I take her.
I... Wait!
Remarkably, the vines and branches stopped. Dalinar hung there, speared by vines that had somehow pushed through his skin. There was no pain, but he felt the tendrils writhing inside his very veins.
Speak.
You'll take Evie from me?
All memories of her. This is the cost. Should I forbear?
Dalinar squeezed his eyes shut.
Evie, I never deserved her. Do it.
The vines and branches surged forward and began to rip away pieces of him from the inside.